Hello everyone, this is Reza Dorrani, Microsoft Business Applications MVP. In this video, I will talk about 7 key points that you need to take into consideration when you're working with SharePoint as a data source with respect to Power Apps. So let's get straight into it. The first key point is SharePoint is not a relational database. Now SharePoint sits on top of SQL Server, which is a relational database system. But SharePoint itself is not a relational database system. SharePoint doesn't support complex data relationships that are typical of relational databases. Examples, a 1:1 relationship, where a record in one table is related to a record in another table. For example, I have an employee, and an employee has an employee number that is associated with an employee. So that's a 1:1 relationship. You can also create 1:many or 1:many relationships. So SharePoint does not have those inbuilt capabilities. There are certain options which I will talk about. Also, there is no transactional rollback. So many a times in Power Apps, when we create multiple lists and we try to create relationships between these lists in SharePoint, we tend to patch multiple SharePoint lists at the same time. And the point to note is that if one patch works, whereas the other operation fails, there is no way for you to perform a transactional rollback in SharePoint. SharePoint has its own challenges, specifically when you're talking about a relational database system. So if I head over to this SharePoint list, I have a list called Power Loaded. And in this list, I have a column called Power Type. In SharePoint, if I have to create this as a lookup to another table, you would have gone ahead and created another list. And in this list, I have my types that I have defined. And if I head back to my Power Loaded list, now because I want to create a relationship between the data that's entered in this list and it is related to a record in the other list, this is what we typically do with SharePoint. Go ahead and create something known as a lookup column. And I create a lookup column that looks up to the secondary list, and then I decide what kind of relationship I would like to enforce as well, restrict delete or cascade delete. You are trying to create these connections, you're trying to connect the dots between these multiple lists that you're trying to set up purely because you're trying to create a relational database in SharePoint, whereas in reality, SharePoint is not a relational database. An example of a relational database is, of course, SQL. Another one is CDS. So in this case, I have the same list that I created in SharePoint, but I have set it up in CDS. Right here, I have the option of directly going ahead and creating my relationship. So if I have multiple entities in CDS, I can straight away go and start setting up my relationships, right? 1:1, 1:1, 1:many, whatever type of relationship I would like to create between these multiple entities through a point and click experience, rather than me having to go ahead and create that lookup column in my one list and then create this relationship. There's a lot of work that you have to do in SharePoint. So very important, once again, if you want to create relational systems or relational databases, don't work with SharePoint as a data source. The next thing is SharePoint can actually handle up to 30 million items. You can have large SharePoint lists and libraries and as large as 30 million items. SharePoint has a list view threshold. Now, many a times we try to create these relationships between these multiple lists. We go ahead and start creating these lookup type columns or these people type columns and so forth. Now there is a threshold limit in SharePoint, and that limit is 12. You cannot have more than 12 columns in your SharePoint list that are of type lookup or person or managed data. And this is a combination of all the three types of columns. Now let me prove this point. Now in this list, I have this view called all items. And in this view, I'm showcasing different types of columns. I have people picker columns, I have lookup columns. And if I head over to the list settings, you will notice that I have created 12 special type of columns. Let's look at them. I have person or group type columns. I have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I have 10 people picker columns, of which two come in by default whenever you create a SharePoint list or library that's created by and modified by, right? So I have already gone ahead and used up 10 people picker columns right here. And I have 2 lookup columns that I have created right here. So I already have 12 columns. Now, if I go ahead and create another column that is of that special type, so let me go ahead and create another people picker column right here. So I've just created another column type. So although I can create these columns, but if I head back to my list, you will notice that I have got an error right here in my list. And the error says the query cannot be completed because the number of lookup columns exceeds the threshold. So when you're viewing data in SharePoint itself, it has that limit. So you cannot go beyond that point. Now, what happens when PowerApps tries to connect to this data source? Let's check it out. If I head back to my PowerApp, and if I go to this second screen, and let's say I add a gallery right here, and I already have the lists connected right here. So here is my power loaded list. I will just refresh it so the latest schema of that list is available right here for me to leverage in my PowerApp. And I'm going to pick my data source as this list. And the moment I pick this, notice I get an error right here. And the error is that you cannot exceed that threshold limit. That means if there's a limit in the database itself, which is SharePoint, PowerApps will not be able to connect to that data source. So it's very important to note that you are going to run into this threshold limit if you're trying to create this complex relational type scenarios. Now, how do I fix this? How do I get around this? So if I head back to my SharePoint list, I see the error right here. Now, if I go to the list settings, please note this is an error in the view. So if I go to the all items view, and let's say I remove this new column from the view that I just created, I'm going to click on OK. And if I head back to my list will show me all the data because in this view, I have gone ahead and only showed specific columns. I have excluded that 13th special type of column, so my view works. Now, if I head back to Power Apps, and if I actually reload my schema, notice I am still going to get that error. And the reason is because when Power Apps connects to SharePoint as a data source, it will fetch all the columns in memory. You cannot define a view in Power Apps. You cannot say, get me only the columns from this view in this list in SharePoint. You cannot do that. When Power Apps connects to SharePoint as a data source, it will fetch all the columns associated with it. When you're connecting to CDS as a data source, you can actually even decide which views you would like to connect to. So you can only pull in those columns. So it's a lot more intuitive. So the only fix in this scenario then for Power Apps is I have to actually go ahead and make sure that I don't exceed that threshold limit. So heading back to my list, I cannot create more than 12 special type of columns. So if I go ahead and delete the column that I just created, if I head back to Power Apps and if I refresh my schema, you will note that all the data starts flowing in. Point number four, the 5,000 item view limit. Now this is a number that you would have heard plenty of times before in SharePoint, specifically in classic SharePoint. If you have a view that is trying to show more than 5,000 records, or if you have a query that you're performing that returns more than 5,000 records, in that case, SharePoint will throw an error. Now, if I head to my SharePoint list, I have a list here called students, and that has exceeded the 5,000 threshold limit. Now, if I go to the all items view, you will notice that there is no error that's showing up in SharePoint. That is because I am currently in modern SharePoint and the modern experience. And what the modern experience does is it does not load all the data at once in memory. Notice it's not showing me all the 5,000 records. As I start scrolling down, it will actually start loading records in batches for me. And Power Apps, when I connect to this list, will actually do the same as long as my data source is delegable with SharePoint support. I will go ahead and add a gallery, and this time I'm connecting to the students list. And notice right here that it has gone ahead and fetched all the data for me. Now, once again, just like it works in SharePoint, even Power Apps does the batching for me. So as I start scrolling down, Power Apps will load the next set of data in memory, and all of that data keeps getting loaded right here for you in an optimized manner. So even though your list view threshold limit exceeds 5,000, if you're connecting to that list, you will be good. The next key point is column indexing. Now, although 5,000 item limit view is a factor, when I'm performing queries on my data set, which in this case is a SharePoint list, and let's say I have a list that has 30 million records in it. In that case, if I'm performing queries on that SharePoint list, if my query is going to return more than 5,000 items, for example, I will run into issues. So how do I get around this? And the answer is column indexing. When you're working with large data sets in SharePoint, you need to understand what column indexing is. So if I go back to my students list, and in this case, I have more than 5,000 items. If I try and perform a filter operation, which is basically a query on this list, so show me all the students that belong to the south zone. If I apply this, this will apply a filter and get all the results for me. Now, if I go to the settings of my list, and let's say this list keeps growing, of course, the performance of my SharePoint queries will also start degrading at the same time. And as you can see right here, it's clearly highlighted that your list has gone above the 5,000 threshold. And there's a nice link here that points out to what you need to do in order to avoid excessive server load when you're performing queries. Remember, PowerApps is performing queries against SharePoint as the data source. If the data source is not going to perform the queries in an optimized manner, in that case, PowerApps will not be able to perform those same queries for you in an optimized manner. So what you end up doing in that scenario is you can go ahead and create something known as indexed columns. So if I know I'm performing a query on a list that's going to grow over time, you can go ahead and start creating indexes for those columns so that when those queries are performed in a much more optimized manner. The key thing here is that although you can create indexes, you can only create a maximum of 20 indexes. That means if I'm performing queries on a SharePoint list, I can only create a maximum of 20 indexes. So when you're working with large lists, plan your indexes smartly because you can only perform queries on 20 columns that are indexed. This also includes sorting. So if I have a gallery that, in this case, I have this gallery that's pointing to the students list. And let's say in this case, I am going to say sort this list based on the created date in descending order. Now this sorting is also a query operation. It's sorting based on the created field. Because I'm performing a query right here on this column, I need to index this column. Now if I further perform additional queries, so filter my students list where the region dot value is equal to south, for example, then in this case, I need to also make sure that I'm also indexing my region, specifically in scenarios where my data source is going to grow over time. Another thing to note about indexes, you cannot create or delete any indexes once your list goes over 20,000 records. If you know your data is growing, go ahead and plan your indexes beforehand. Once your list crosses 20,000 records, there is no ways for you to create a new index or to delete an index. The only way you can perform creation and deletion of indexes then is if you reduce the number of records in your list below 20,000. The next one is item level permissions. Now SharePoint can perform list or library level security as well as item level security. So you can secure your rows in your SharePoint lists. Typically we leverage item level permissions wherein we break security on that specific list item in SharePoint. Now please note there is a supported limit of 50,000, but the recommended general limit is just 5,000. So if you know your list is going to grow and if you need item level permissions for every item in that list, SharePoint is probably not the best data source. Let's say my SharePoint list has 50,000 records. Every row has item level security assigned. In that case, when PowerApps performs the query goes to SharePoint, and SharePoint itself does not perform that query in an optimized manner because once you exceed the number 5,000, for your item level permissions, the performance starts degrading. That is because it has to go and even check the security while it's performing the query because it should only return the items that are secured. So SharePoint, once again, is not a great data source if you're trying to deal with large lists and level permissions. And finally, PowerApps supports delegation for SharePoint. So delegation is the process in which PowerApps does not do the work of performing the query, rather it delegates the work to the underlying data source. SharePoint, which is a standard connector, supports delegation. That means when PowerApps performs a query, SharePoint can do the work. There are caveats in this as well. And if you look at the connector documentation for SharePoint, there is a delegation section highlighted right here. So when you're dealing with specific types of columns, there are specific scenarios where the delegation would be yes, and there are specific scenarios where the delegation would be no. So for example, I cannot sort based on a lookup column in SharePoint. I cannot perform that kind of sorting mechanism. So you need to be aware of these different facts. And If you're not aware of Delegation, I've done a full video series on Delegation. I will plug that link in the description of this video, so please do check that out. But please bear in mind that without Delegation, you cannot work with large data sources or large lists in SharePoint. So you have to adhere to the Delegation factors. So I went ahead and gave you the 7 key points today. Please take this into consideration when you're working with SharePoint as a data source with respect to Power Apps. If you liked what I showcased today, do like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching.